हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू लेट अस मास्टर इंग्लिश. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू मॉडल वर्ब्स. कंटेंट्स ऑफ दिस वीडियो आर व्हाट आर मॉडल्स और मॉडल ऑक्सिलरीज, हाउ डू वी यूज मॉडल वर्ब्स, लिस्ट ऑफ मॉडल वर्ब्स, वेरियस यूजेस ऑफ मॉडल वर्ब्स. देन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मॉडल वर्ब्स. And today we are going to learn usage of have to, has to, had to and used to in detail. And at the end of the video, there is going to be a homework for you. And here you can also find answers to lecture 3 practice exercise. So let's get started. Students, first of all, let us see what are modals. Modals are also known as modal verbs, modal auxiliary verbs or modal auxiliaries. They are special verbs which behave irregularly in English. They are different from normal verbs like play, run, take, go, come, etc. Modal verbs give additional information about the function of the main verb that follows it. Modal verb is always followed by a principal verb. Modal verbs add a meaning to the main verb by expressing possibility, ability, permission, or obligation. They have a great variety of communicative functions. First, let us understand the difference between verb and modal verb. Let us understand this with example, I speak English. So here speak is an action word. It is a normal verb. I am telling you I speak English. Now let us add modal verb before speak. I can speak English. Now here by adding this modal verb can, we have changed the meaning of the main verb. Here, what am I doing? Here, I am telling you my ability that I am able to speak English. I can speak English. You should speak English. Now, here I have added the modal verb should. Now, by adding should, what have I done? Here, should is used for giving advice. I'm advising you to speak English. So students, by adding modal verbs, we add a meaning to the main verb. And these modal verbs express possibility, permission, ability, obligation, and so on. Modal auxiliaries express the mode or manner of actions denoted by the verbs. For example, she has to work hard. He used to help you. Now students, I hope you know the difference between normal verb and modal verb. How do we use modal verbs? Modal auxiliaries are used along with main verbs. They are never used alone. They are not used alone. For example, I used to live there when I was a boy. So here first we use subject, then we use modal verb used to, and live is the main verb. One more example for you. We had to get up early yesterday. So first we use subject, that is we, followed by modal verb had to, and then the main verb get up. So this is how we use modal verbs. Modal verbs are always used before the main verb. Now students, here is a list of modals. So I have made this table. In the first column, modal verbs are there. In second column, negative of modal verb. And in third column, contracted form of modal verb. For example, can. Negative of can is cannot. And when we use negative of a modal verb, it can be written in contracted form. So, cannot can also be written as can't. Same way, could not, couldn't. May not. And we generally don't use contracted form of may not. Might not, mightn't. Shall not, shan't. Should not, shouldn't. Will not, won't. Would, negative is would not, and contracted form is wouldn't. Ought to, ought not to, oughtn't. Dare not, daren't. Need not, needn't. So all these modal verbs we have already studied in my previous three videos. Now students, let us see use of modal verbs. Modal verbs are used to express various functions such as, number one, permission. When you have to seek permission, when you have to give permission, we make use of modal verb. For example, may I borrow your umbrella? So here we have used modal verb may to seek permission. So modal verbs are also used to express ability, to be able to. For example, I can swim across the river. So here I am telling my ability. Obligation, moral duty. Children should obey their parents. Prohibition, jo aapko nahi karna chahiye. You mustn't wear jeans at work. It means it's not allowed. Lack of necessity. For example, you needn't have wasted your time in this useless activity. Yani jo aapne kaam kiya par aapko nahi karna chahiye tha. Advice, you should do regular exercise. Probability, for example, prices ought to come down soon. Promise, you shall have a holiday tomorrow. So these are some of the functions expressed by modal verbs. So whenever you have to speak about permission, ability, obligation, prohibition, lack of necessity, advice, probability, promise, then you can make use of modal verbs. Now students, how to use modal verbs? Let us pursue further. A modal verb does not change according to the number or person of the subject. Students, you have studied tenses where I have told you that whenever you change number, that is singular or plural, person means first person, second person or third person, the verb changes. For example, we say I drive, we drive, he drives. I am driving, you are driving, he is driving. But here, let us see whether modal verb changes or not. For example, I can drive. I is first person singular. We can drive. Now, we is first person plural. You can drive. You is second person. He can drive. He is third person singular. They can drive. They is third person plural. But here with all the subjects we have used can. So what does it show? It shows that a modal verb does not change according to the number or person of the subject. Whatever the subject is, modal verb remains the same. Point number two. Only the first form of the verb can be used after a modal auxiliary. Now you know modals, that is can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should. After these we use first form of verb. Here are some examples. He can run fast. I may go. I should complete my task. It might rain. Now here can, should, may, might, or all are modal verbs. And the main verbs are run, go, complete, rain. So all these are first form of verbs. So after a modal verb, we use first form of verb. But after modal, if have is there, so after have, we use third form of verb. For example, I could have gone. Point number three, modals can be used alone in response to a question. Students, earlier I told you that modal verbs cannot be used alone. But if somebody is asking you a question using a modal verb and you are answering, you are replying to that question, that time modal verb can be used alone. For example, can you lift this box? So the response is, I can. So we need not complete the sentence like, I can lift this box. So here, I can make sense. Will you help the needy? I will. May I come in? Yes, you can, you may. Point number four, modals when joined with not to form a negative can be contracted. This we have seen in the table also. For example, she cannot jump high can be written as she can't jump high. He would not listen can also be written as he wouldn't listen. Now, students, let us learn some characteristics of modal verbs. Modal verbs never change their form. They can't, you cannot add S-E-D or I-N-G with a modal verb. For example, she can play the piano beautifully. We cannot write as she can play the piano beautifully or she can playing the piano beautifully. This is wrong. They are always followed by an infinitive without to. That is the bare infinitive. It means after a modal verb, we don't use to. Only ought is an exception to this rule. We write ought to. It does require a to infinitive, but otherwise behaves like other modal verbs. For example, they must work on the project. If you write they must to work on the project, this is wrong. Modal verbs are used to express certainty, possibility, willingness, obligation, necessity, or ability. Now, students, today let us study has to and have to. Has to and have to are used to express some compulsion, necessity, or obligation in the present or future tense. The subject of have to is obliged or forced to act by a separate external power. For example, the law or school rules. For example, I have to leave now. Mujhe ab jana padega. So here have to shows that I do not want to go. It is not my willingness. Par jabardasti mujhe jana padega due to some external power or force. Raj has to finish his work on time. I have to withdraw money from the bank. In France, you have to drive on the right as per the law. In India, school children have to wear a uniform. मतलब वो यूनिफॉर्म पहनना पसंद नहीं करते हैं, उन्हें पहननी पड़ती है. तो यहाँ पे ये वाली सेंस आती है, करना पड़ता है, जबरदस्ती. तो वहाँ पे आपको has to या have to लगाना पड़ता है. John has to wear a tie at work. इसका मतलब उसे टाई पहनना पसंद नहीं है, पर जब भी वो काम पर ऑफिस जाता है तो उसे टाई पहननी पड़ती है. In negatives and questions, have to is used with do, does and did. Did is used for past. They don't have to worry about food. She doesn't have to finish the drawing. Jack doesn't have to go. So for has to, we use doesn't have to. For have to, we use don't have to. Let us study this rule in detail in next slide. Now, rules for using has to or have to. Students, have to is used with I, you, we, they in affirmative sentences. For example, you have to work hard. Has to is used with he, she, it in affirmative sentences. For example, he has to cook his own meals. Negatives and questions are formed both ways, that is, with or without do. Don't have to is used with I, you, we, they in negative sentences. For example, you don't have to work hard. This can also be written as you haven't to work hard. Doesn't have to is used with he, she, it in negative sentences. For example, he doesn't have to cook his own meals or he hasn't to cook his own meals. Questions. For questions, we use do or does plus subject plus have to. For example, does he have to cook his own meals or has he to cook his own meals? Had to. Had to is used to express necessity or obligation in the past. The expression had to is the past tense of has to and have to. Has to and have to हम बेटा कहाँ use करते हैं? यहाँ हमें ये sense बतानी होती है कि ये काम करना पड़ता है. और had to हम कहाँ use करते हैं? करना पड़ता था. Let us see examples of affirmative sentences. The villagers had to use kerosene lamps 10 years ago. गांव में लोग kerosene lamps उन्हें use करने पड़ते थे. वो भी electricity use करना चाहते थे, but वो available नहीं थी. As a child, I had to go to school on foot. मुझे पैदल स्कूल जाना पड़ता था. He had to move the almira himself. I had to get up early. मुझे जल्दी उठना पड़ता था. इसका मतलब मैं जल्दी उठना चाहता नहीं था, पर उठना पड़ता था. Negative. I did not have to get up early. Question. Did I have to get up early? Now, next modal is used to. Let us learn uses of used to. We use this expression to talk about habits or repeated actions in the past which we don't do in the present. We also use it to talk about states in the past which are no longer true. जो काम आप पास्ट में करते थे, मतलब जो आप अब नहीं करते. For example, I used to have long hair. It means now I have short hair. मेरे लंबे बाल हुआ करते थे, इसका मतलब अब नहीं है. He used to smoke, but now he doesn't smoke. They used to live in India. So what does it mean? Now they don't live in India. Now students, it's homework time. Here's a practice exercise for you. Choose the correct words and rewrite the sentences. Now here you have to check according to the subject what you have to use. So please pick up the right one and rewrite the sentence. One more question. Fill in the blanks with modals. So here, students, we have studied modals before also in lecture 1, 2 and 3. So using all those modals, you have to fill in these blanks. Now, students, I hope you would have done your homework, which was given in lecture 3. So please pick up your notebooks and match your answers here. Now, second slide, here also you can find answers to question number 2. Thank you very much for watching this video, and for more such videos, please subscribe to my channel and please like, comment and share my videos with your friends. Thank you very much.